Hey, welcome back to Milton Daily Homes. Chuck here. We have a list of five properties today. So it starts to wind down a little bit at the end of August. So it's pretty typical. So I'm leaving tomorrow. I'm gone for a week. And we're going to try something on the team. It'll be a bit of an experiment, but I'm going to have the other team members choose some of their favorite picks. And we'll assemble it and we'll have them send it to you. So hopefully we can just keep the flow so you're not missing listings for a week. And I don't know, it's something new. We'll try it out. Let us know what you think. Let's get to this list here. So we've got 235 Bronte, number 80, 316, 888. And the values in this complex have tended to be a little bit lower than some of the other ones. I don't know why, because it's actually a pretty good area. There's a park right in the middle. There are a fair amount of stairs when you go through this one. They've done the cabinets here, a little bit of extra space. Same color choice as the kitchen. It's modern. They've increased the baseboard size. I think they'll get it, and I think this one may be one that kind of pushes the prices back up to the level of the other ones. Overall, it looks pretty good. It's a little bit more of a modern look, which fundamentally is different than the outside of the home, which looks a little bit older. But anyway, it's pretty much the best way to get a three-bedroom townhouse with a yard for the lowest price. You have the extra condo fees. Paying for this one is probably the equivalent of buying maybe a 360 to 365 townhouse without any fees. But remember, people give the fees a hard time. When your roof, when your windows, when all that stuff needs replacing, you don't have to pay for it. And so if you buy something on Bernard or McDowell, for example, where they are freehold homes, but they're getting close, that some of them are past 10 years, you're close to a lot of work being done. So I do think that this is good value for somebody who, even like with a pet that needs a bit of a backyard. I like it. So Jervis is 384.9, and so it is, it's 1130 square feet. It's got one bathroom upstairs, decent looking kitchen. So even though the stairs are lighter, you can kind of put a lighter floor here. We put a really nice one. I'm going to share with you a sneak preview of a home that we're launching today. So you get about a 24-hour head start on the other buyers at 816 Gifford. And it's awesome. Deep lot, 1370 square feet. I'll put the link down below. And anyway, put some hardwood in here. Really, this model has sold for close to $400,000. It's a good quiet street. It's priced very aggressively, so I have no doubts that that one's going to sell at or above asking in probably a couple days. Dimont is 439, and it's called a Castle something. Can't remember the model name. It's around 1,800 square feet. It's got the double car garage here, but it doesn't really have a backyard. It's got a laneway access to the double garage. That's a laminate floor. My parents put that in their basement. Very similar kind of material. It's almost like a vinyl laminate. And it's pretty good. I'm impressed with that. I think that the vinyl one is actually a little bit better than the wood for an area like that. So no basements really in this one. Three stories. You've got your coffered ceiling in the family room here. There's a little office nook. The kitchen looks like it's got some upgraded countertops. And three bedrooms upstairs. So this is really the cheapest way to get a double car garage, because you're paying probably more than $520 for anything with a backyard. And at least you don't have a lot of neighbors on the side. You got a little bit of traffic happening on Dimont and potentially whatever the cross street is. But I like this one. I think it's a good price point. It's a good layout. And if you don't need that yard, you still have a deck above the garage, but you don't have an actual backyard fenced where the kids can play. And no, you can't put a hot tub on top of that. I've already checked into it. So Ben Fleet is 450. It's a semi-detached. Based on the room sizes, I'm guessing it's possibly a Brent Grove. Backs onto green space. It's a little close to the train tracks, but that doesn't seem to interfere with value, especially because you've got the berm, which is the sloping hill that prevents some of the noise from happening. Without pictures, I've got to say, you know what, it's probably in a range where it's marketable, just based on what I'm seeing their size and guessing what kind of home. Galbraith is 619, and you know, it's interesting, when I look through this home, the family room, it could be the picture, but I have a feeling this is a smaller family room. And yeah, everything just looks a little bit older. And when they bought the home, I bet you it's and the lot's great. You can't even buy a 45-foot lot anymore. But it just has this look. Like, here's the thing. If you watch old highlights of something like Beverly Hills 90210 from the 90s, I mean, the stuff they wore, you look at it and you go, I wouldn't wear that anymore. And it's almost like some of the homes, like the Mattamy homes, some of the homes in this area that are 10, 12 years old, is that the styles have changed. And so you kind of look and you go, okay, maybe back then it was okay, but the lighter honey colored wood, all the things that were cool back then, just don't have the same kind of flair. And maybe it comes back, I don't know, but it looks a little bit old fashioned. I say this all the time to people who have homes between the 5 and 10 year mark, is that you are competing in Milton against homes that are a year or 2 years old. And yes, the lots are a little closer together, but the homes, even brass knobs in the old area versus the kind of brushed nickel stainless steel look, it's different, and you can tell. So you really have to kind of be aware of that, and put your buyer hat on and look at it as a seller to say, what are buyers choosing from right now? What else is in the 620 range? So anyway, long story short, it's about 2,500 square feet on paper without a finished basement and a deeper lot. It's probably in the right zone, but I could see people coming in here and saying, well, I'm gonna have to change this and that. And most people, what they do is they knock that off the asking price instead of saying, if I put that work in, could it be worth a little bit more? We just sold a Mattamy house, very nicely finished inside, around actually a little bit smaller than this, but modern, tasteful, nice, and that was up in the mid 630s. So, there you go. Could you put 15 or 20 into this one to really recharge it? Absolutely, for sure. So that's the list for today. If you have any questions, give us a call. And officially, the videos are done for a week, but hopefully, we're going to continue the emails. And it's kind of a grand experiment. I don't know how it's going to turn out, but it's probably going to be kind of interesting and always, something different here at Daily Home. So, we'll see you later. Take care.